Speaking of Chief Bauer, the members of the Foggy Crossing Volunteer Fire Department participated in a controlled burn last Saturday. A burn occurs when a condemned building is purposely set alight and the firemen practice extinguishing it. You might call it a dress rehearsal of sorts, a chance for the hardy smoke eaters to rehearse the latest firefighting techniques and do what firefighters love to do best, play with fire. And so it came to be that early Saturday morning, Chief Bauer rounded up the troops and they headed out to burn an abandoned house north of town. It should be pointed out that a rather large percentage of the houses in Foggy Crossing appear to be abandoned. As a result, Harvey Bungle had a toasty little blaze going on Freddie Postel's front porch before Freddie came roaring out the door and extinguished the flames with his size 16 barn boots. He then threatened to extinguish Harvey in much the same manner. At this point, Harvey realized he was off target by one mailbox. Freddie Postel is a large and simple man, so Harvey just capped his gas can and hiked right out the driveway. Chief Bauer backed the pumper out of Mrs. Postel's flower bed, and the whole crew moved one mailbox north. Once the fellas got the right house stoked up, Chief Bauer was in his glory. Standing at the controls of the pumper, he barked orders left and right. His nimble fingers flew over the controls without hesitation. He was the very picture of professionalism. "Charge line two," yelled Harvey Bungle. "Charging line two," hollered Chief Bauer, selecting a lever on his control panel and throwing open the valve on line two, sending several hundred pounds of pressurized water rushing into the hose. "Charge line three," yelled Harvey Bungle. "Charging line three," hollered Chief Bauer with aplomb, grabbing another lever. Unfortunately for Chief Bauer, this time he grabbed the wrong lever and charged line four, which was still neatly folded atop the pumper, although not for long. It sprang to life like a spring-loaded snake in a peanut can. By the time the chief got the valve shut down, he was as red as the pumper, and the hose nozzle had flailed around and knocked out all the taillights. Just about that time, the women's auxiliary pulled up with a broiler full of hot dogs and a cooler of pop. This, of course, was a major distraction for the crew, and their controlled burn began to act decidedly uncontrolled. Realizing that the women's auxiliary had caused the loss of more than one burning structure in the past, the chief took a running jump into the pumper cab and grabbed the PA mic, intending to give a few orders and get things back under control. I say the chief jumped. Actually, he tripped over line two just as he launched, so it would be more accurate to say he swan dived. This would be a big, ugly swan. Into the cab. Landed belly first, right over the front seat, and started sliding back out. I also said he grabbed the PA mic. Actually, he grabbed for it. What he really grabbed was the hand brake release. The fact that Chief Bauer grabbed the hand brake release was not a problem until it released. The fact that the hand brake had released and that the pumper was parked slightly uphill from the flaming house was not a problem either, except that Harvey Bungle had pulled the backup wheel chucks out to use for a stool while he ate his hot dog. With Chief Bauer belly first across the front seat, the pumper started rolling backward toward the burning house, which by this time was crackling along quite nicely. With a look in his eyes like a man whose life insurance premiums aren't up to date, the check had been on his dashboard for the last 3 weeks, ever since Lily filled it out for him. "Can I trust you to do one simple little errand?" she asked. "Don't be silly," said he. The chief spun around and finally came up to a sitting position. First thing the chief did was grab the handbrake and give it a yank. Came right off in his hand. "I've been meaning to fix that," said Harvey Bungle, who was sitting on his wheel chuck enjoying a hot dog with ketchup and relish. "Hey, Bernice, you guys bring any onions?" Things were getting fairly warm at the back of the pumper by now. Matter of fact, the taillights might have melted if they hadn't all been knocked out. With his eyes bugging out, "Look at his eyes bugging out," said Harvey Bungle. Chief Bauer jammed on the brakes with one foot and stabbed the clutch with his other. With one eye on the mirror and one eye on Harvey Bungle, whom he fully intended to run over as soon as possible, the chief threw the pumper into gear and hit the gas. "You know," said Harvey, "I wonder if anyone told the chief that the shifter decal is on upside down." Has been ever since I fixed the tranny. No one had told the chief, but he didn't care. He was much too busy rocketing straight backward into the burning house. God works in strange ways, to say nothing of Harvey Bungle, and he was working that day. When he hit the house, the chief had a pretty good head of steam, and it collapsed in a shower of sparks. When the smoke cleared, the vacuum caused by the collapse had put the fire out. By this time, several of the fellows had stopped eating. Chief Bauer had stopped breathing. As for Harvey Bungle, he had departed for home, having just recalled that he had promised Bernice he would starch and iron her doily collection that afternoon. Somebody snuck in the fire hall last week and hung big tags numbered 1 through 4 from each of the valve controls. Chief Bauer was reportedly not amused.